Turn off that fake news and tune into We the People News if you want to have a better idea of what's really going on in the world. This is one of the Patriot sites that I listen to and get information from. Another good one is Real Raw News. Another good one is Before It's News. And on the spiritual side, a good channel that I listen to is The Prophecy Club. And also Bree Keaton, that's another good channel. Another good channel is Ark News. That's a good one. But the thing with the Patriot channels you might want to be careful about is I don't think they're too familiar about the tricks and the antics of the fallen angels. The fallen angels can shape shift. They can appear as dead saints. They could come down pretending to be space brothers from other worlds or other planets or other dimensions, and they will come like angels of light, things like that. They'll come down pretending to be the heroes, dressed like people from the space movies that we've been brainwashed by over the years. And they'll call themselves good guy sounding names like Galactic Federation of Light or the Ashtar Command and all this stuff. But they're just fallen angels. And they have this whole charade that they're playing with the reptilians. You got the reptilians that look ugly. And then you got the fallen angels that look like heroes, and they're all on Satan's side. That's the thing. Ain't none of them good. They're all on Satan's side. God's angels don't really come down here making deals with man. They don't make deals with man at all. They just come bringing a message from God, and that's it. And it's like the word coming from God, and as a message and things like that. They rescue sometimes and things like that, but they're not sitting down having card games with man or going after human women and all that stuff like that. It's like the angels of God go strictly by the word of God, the Bible. And one of the most accurate versions we have is Authorized King James Version or King James 1611 or the Geneva Bible and things of that nature. And I don't want to hear anything about all the bad things King James did. King James didn't write the Bible. He just made sure that no fables were put in there. But it's a pretty good translation. It's enough truth in there for you to make it to heaven and to settle. And when a Christian has a settled word that lines up with the word in heaven, there's a power flow on it called the anointing, and that destroys Satan's kingdom. So that's why Satan had to make all these counterfeit Bibles like NIV, Jehovah Witness Bible, and all those fake Bibles came from the 23rd Nestle's text. Came from those corrupt manuscripts. That's where all those fake Bibles came from, and it was made. It was published by Satanists, Rupert Murdoch, the porn publisher, and Satanists. And it's a patent on those fake Bibles. Ain't no patent on the real Bibles and stuff like that. In the Bible, it talks about the strong delusion of 2 Thessalonians 2, where it will be so convincing that if possible, it would even fool some of God's elect. So that would be these fallen angels coming down, pretending to be on God's side or pretending to be the heroes and stuff like that. And then man has this technology called Project Bluebeam and voice to skull technology, where they could broadcast a sound into your head and make you think God's talking to you. Or they could put holograms up in the sky, make you think you're seeing the UFOs and all that stuff, or you seeing a Jesus coming or any religious figure. So they have all this technology to use against you. So, to not be fooled by the fallen angels and the Antichrist that they're going to promote, because these fallen angels, they have a Jesus figure, and he's going to be looking like that false image of Jesus that you see in the Bible with the blonde hair and blue eyes, which is really Caesar or Caesar Borgia, if I said that right. But a real Jesus, he's not described to look that way in the Bible. The Bible don't describe him to look like that. When a real Jesus comes back, he's gonna come back burning up his enemies with fire from his word, from his mouth, which comes out like a sword. The real Jesus doesn't come down making world peace and making deals with man and all that stuff. That's what the Antichrist is gonna do. And he comes back before the real Jesus comes on the scene. And he's gonna fix everything, and everybody's gonna love him, and he's gonna be so wonderful and all this and that. That's the Antichrist. The real Jesus, he comes down kicking butt. First time he came down as a lamb, and what did they do? He came down as a peaceful lamb and they killed him. They tortured him and they put him on a cross and they killed him. When he comes back this time, he's going to be whooping. He's going to be whooping his enemies because the whole world is going to be united against him because evidently the fallen angels turns everyone against the biblical Jesus, the biblical Christ, the biblical God. So looking at that taking shape now. So the Patriots need to reach out to ministries like Prophecy Club, the Prophecy Club, and find out about fallen angels and stuff and find out how to do spiritual warfare because weapons of man is not going to work against fallen angels. You're going to have to do spiritual warfare. So you need to get in contact with real prophets like Prophet Leslie Johnson or Amanda Grace, prophets like that, you know, even Mark Taylor, you know. So that's what I would suggest to the Patriots so that they can be up to speed on the spiritual side. They got the physical side, but, you know, to a degree, you know, your physical weapons ain't going to work against fallen angels. I'll tell you that right now. You're going to have spiritual warfare, the word of God, Psalm 91 and things of that nature. All right. So let's let you know about all that, you know, so that's what you're dealing with when you're dealing with the Patriot site. Some of them know about the fallen angels. Some of them don't know. But the entire world is going to be fooled by these beings. You know, the whole stuff that they're doing with the comic book characters, the Marvel and the super soldiers and Captain America and all these X-Men and all this stuff like this. This is what they're making an underground basis because they're putting together in these bio labs animal and human DNA, making hybrids. And they're going to bring out all these hybrids that they've made in these bases and say that they're from outer space. They'll say, yeah, these boys right here, they're from outer space. These are space boys. Yeah, they're fooling you. It's all a lie. Anyway, I'm going to play We the People News. This is one of the channel. Like I said before, Real Raw News is a good one. Before It's News, that's a good one. And the Prophecy Club. Stay away from Alex Jones. That's Control Opposition. Stay away from him. All right, here we go. We the People News right here.
Watch what happens over the next couple of weeks. We'll be right back.
period of time at Restored Republic via HECR. Update for Sunday, May 1st, 2022 by Judy Byington. Mayday, mayday, mayday. Sunday, May 1st. Global currency reset is official. Russia-Ukraine war. Trump Jr. calls Ukraine one of the most corrupt countries on earth and says the U.S. shouldn't be giving it money. And as you know, the Kyiv regime is Nazi. It's part of the Azov Battalion, which our CIA helped to train. So our CIA deep state trained the Nazis over there for a while, and they are not our... They are our enemy. We should not be sending them money. The Ukrainian people are the ones oppressed by the regime itself, the government. Pentagon advisor Colonel Doug McGregor on Russia-Ukraine war. The issue for the Russians from the very beginning has been, how do we proceed without killing large numbers of civilians and inflicting a lot of property damage? And Putin gave very strict orders from the outset that they were to avoid these things. The problem with avoiding it is that it has slowed the progress of the operation to the point where it has given false hope, both to the Ukrainians. I think has been seized on by people in the West to try and convince the world that a defeat is in progress, when in fact, the opposite is the case. So the mainstream media in the West is constantly feeding us propaganda and trying to convince us to support giving arms to Ukraine, the regime, and trying to make Russia look like they're losing. And it's not the case. And what they're doing is prolonging the war, causing the Ukrainian people to suffer because they're caught in the crossfire. So it's really evil, to be honest with you, to be sending money to the Ukraine regime and to be supporting that. So the war itself at this stage of the game would be decided very, very rapidly, permanently. If Putin were to give the order and allow the forces to disregard the concern for civilians and property damage, but he hasn't done that. He has continued to negotiate, even though he recognizes that the people sitting across from him really are not in a position to deliver very much. They are being told what to do. It's very obvious that Washington wants this to continue as long as possible in the hopes that Russia will be desperately harmed. I just don't see that happening. 70% of the Russian population is firmly behind Vladimir Putin. That's a very large percentage in any conflict for any president to enjoy. And remember, patriots that are awake and know what's really going on and not following the mainstream media also understand what Putin is up against. Ukrainian forces are still active, are entirely surrounded, cut off, and isolated in various towns and cities. The Ukrainian forces are incapable of anything but an occasional pinprick attack on something that doesn't appear to be very robust or dangerous. So the war, for all intents and purposes, has been decided. Russia has, if you want to pick a winner, it's Russia. Russia is basically taking a lot of the arms that are coming through Ukraine from Poland and elsewhere and destroying them, or just taking, you know, confiscating them. Lots of white hats in behind the scenes operations. Putin was going to be assassinated by the Davos Rockefeller CIA deep state operations for betraying them. The plot to destroy Putin and take over the Russian country was the plan of the New World Order. Fortunately, the White Hats in the EU, US, and Russia all stepped in and started mass arrests through EU, intel agencies, and Russian military black hat leaders. Putin decided to kill three birds with one stone: biolabs, coup assassination, and bring down the central banking system by going into Ukraine. Colonel Doug McGregor, the biggest lie I've heard repeated on television is Russian troops have been told to deliberately murder civilians, Ukrainian civilians. It's absurd. It's nonsense. Nothing could be further from the truth.
Pharma. Yeah, this is...